Senators. Second last game for the Toronto Maple Leafs as they face off at the Canadian Tire Center. And we're underway as the puck goes down into the Ottawa zone right off the hop. Far side. Tkachuk can't get the puck out. Leafs get it back into the slot. Matthews going wide. Took a shot. Pad save. The rebound goes back of the goal. Now by Batherson. And Batherson will get it on the wing and it's going to be shot into the Toronto zone. Leafs back in their own zone. No score here. Oh, it is Nylander keeping it in. Brody was sort of in a rock and a hard place there as he tried to hold it in at the blue line, but a bouncing puck off the stick then of Nick Paul had to be stopped by Anderson. And a whistle here.
I think we've got another penalty coming up, and I think this one's going to the Leafs. And I thought I saw perhaps a tripping sign.
To get to it, brought out now by the Pens, and a shot from the blue line is blockered away nicely by Anderson. Round the boards to the near side. Keep the puck in the Toronto zone. Now back of the net for Shane Pinto. He's taken to the boards. Nylander trying to free it up as it's poked back towards the blue line. Sent to the near wing for Zaitsev. A shot. Scores! A shot from the right point. Went right by everyone and finds the corner of the net. And the former Leaf defenseman has the Senators out in front, 1-0.
That's exactly what we talked about earlier, how the Ottawa Senators beat you. It's amazing how many times they're able to score on point shots, screens, or redirections.
They all showed up and threw hats over his fence into his backyard, which was kind of neat as it's knocked down into the Ottawa zone to start the period and now cleared by the Sens back into center ice. Carried to center ice by Nick Paul. Played in on the right side. Brown makes a nice play going to the net. And the stop made there by Anderson. And the wraparound attempt by Connor Brown didn't work either. Back in for Simmons, but it's knocked away. Simmons controls, now tries to jam it out in front of the net. Kerfoot will dish it back into the slot. Muzzin, a drive and scores! Don't look now, but it's the number two power play that works. And the shot from the point set up by Thornton has tied the game at ones on Jake Muzzin's third or fourth goal of the season.
And a lot of this begins with Wayne Simmons, who is to the right of Gustafson below the goal line and says, I don't have a play. I'm going to go fourth and inches and try to get it to the front of the net.
Ice here with Marner carrying in over the line with Spezza. Marner goes into the slot, took a shot, and that went off the crossbar and out of play. But the Leafs with that record and a winning percentage of 783 is the best in the National Hockey League. Absolutely. There's a centering pass, comes back into the slot, a backhand try to the near side. Anderson got across against Tkachuk. His best save of the game right there. Along the boards, the Leafs keep the puck in, but it is knocked out at center ice. And a foot race here with Connor Brown getting in behind his man. And the shot is stopped by Anderson. The rebound jammed at. They score. Connor Brown shorthanded. His fifth goal shorthanded this year and his 21st of the season. And Ottawa has a 2-1 lead.
Well, the Lord giveth. The Leafs with a power play goal and then give up a shorthanded marker. Austin Matthews and Mitch Marner get caught turning the puck over, and then Freddie Anderson has no idea. He follows Connor Brown, who comes off the right wing side, cuts to the front, goes forehand, backhand, and Anderson is in full spin mode and has no idea where the puck is.
Reverses his field, but ran into traffic right along the boards, then gave the puck away, then able to restore it. But now the Senators have it again, playing it back, and another penalty coming, this to Toronto. Shot from the blue line is wide. There's a rebound! Did Anderson get there?
No, I think this is in. Freddie Anderson turned and was late, and I think this banks off him. Morgan Rielly was going to pick up either a cross-checking or a boarding penalty. And the Ottawa Senators, is this Stützle going to get credit for it?
I think it might be Parker Kelly, but we'll...
If it's Kelly, it's his first NHL goal. Yeah, this would have been a cross-check on Morgan Rielly, and it all starts when Rielly gave the puck away.
Yeah, it's Kelly. Anderson. Better ice area for Engvall. He has a man going hard to the net. Can't get it to him, and when he did, he was in too tight as Kerfoot deflected that right into the chest of the goalkeeper. Nylander to the blue line, near side for Hall. Hall waiting for traffic as it comes back. Now a pass goes in wide of the net. Nylander centers, and Tavares scores! That didn't take long. Nylander with almost a blind look. He must have heard the captain yelling for it. But once it got to Tavares, it was upstairs in a hurry, and it is 3-2.
And just before that, Leafs have it at the point, and there is nobody to the front of the net. So all the defense could do is lob one on the backhand of the backboards.
Knocked away there by the Leafs. Brody trying to fish it away, but it's grabbed by Batherson. Back to the point it comes, and a shot is high and wide of the Leaf goal, and the rebound has gone out of play with 38 seconds remaining in the period. Muzzin has drawn the additional assist on the Tavares goal. Senators are very respectable, 16-1-2. When they've had the lead heading to the third period.
And the most recent loss had set up Cole Caulfield's first NHL goal in overtime. Montreal was actually down 2-0 early in the third period to the Senators.
Galchenyuk possibly is going to be left out. A centering pass, and that's knocked abound. And Anderson finally found it in the blue paint as it lay there rather ominously for a time.
That was his positioning, allowed him to make the save. But I don't think he had any idea where it was.
Now the Sens get it out into neutral ice. A left wing feed going hard to the net is Batherson. He stopped and then got a shot away, and it was knocked away by Frederik Andersen. Josh Norris playing it around back of the net. And now here's Tkachuk trying to work in on the left wing with a shot off the shoulder of Andersen that shook him up a little bit. Butterstep gains the zone. Now looks for a man to pass it to. Chipped it back in along the boards for Tavares. Tavares back of the net for Matthews. Matthews to Tavares again. Coming out in front. And a pass in front. Shot off the goalpost. No, they scored. Austin Matthews so fast in and out. And has tied the game here in the third period.
After some great work by Nick Foligno, the only reason I knew it was in was the official in the far corner was pointing. As this puck was on and off the stick of Austin Matthews in the blink of an eye.
Corner and back out at center ice with just 4 seconds remaining. They've not put the assists on the board yet, but I would think Foligno would get one there if I'm not mistaken.
Dinette, Austin Matthews had his 40th.
So the Leafs to the left and the Senators to the right. Toronto will start with the puck, but they give it away. Here's Tkachuk trying to work in front of the goal. A shot scores! Didn't take long. A giveaway by Mitch Marner. And it is Josh Norris who scores in overtime just seconds into the extra time. And the Maple Leafs will fall 4-3.
And we saw the Leafs the last time it was in Montreal. Marner and Matthews had a 2-on-0. They botched that. Here the Leafs actually win the draw. Marner gets it, but tries to chip it and reverse it. Back to Morgan Rielly. Brady Tkachuk picks it up. It's now a 2-on-1. The pass gets through Morgan Rielly, and the puck on the shot by Norris gets through Freddie Andersen. As Anderson's a little late and a little clumsy getting over. Not to hang it on him, but the Ottawa Senators and their season finale win it in overtime. Justin Hall had an overtime goal the last time the Leafs won in Ottawa. But was that quick. Win a draw, and seconds later, it's in your own net.
It did not take long. That is a fact. So the Maple Leafs will gain a point. Now 77 on the season, and that will tie them with Pittsburgh and Washington, who have completed their years, but it will give the Leafs an advantage because of regulation wins at this point. No, it'll tie them with Pittsburgh and Washington. So that will be interesting to see what the tiebreaker would be when you haven't even played against one another.
I guess it would have to be goal differential.
I would think, yep. So we'll wait and see, but another game to be played, and that is against the Winnipeg Jets on Friday night.